In the previous video of this series, we created this image, colored it, added a mask to it. Now let's select all those nodes and press shift spacebar, UND, underlay, move this over a bit. I really don't want the merge to be in here, so let's bring this out and deselect everything. Alt click on just the underlay, press F2 and name this. I'm also going to right click, go to set color and give it this violet color. Find the image that you want, bring it in. Like the previous one, this is masked out. It's a PNG. I'm going to press 1 to preview it on the left. What we can do is make sure we name this. So with it selected, press F2. I'll call this media in underscore photo left. I'm going to bring this up a bit here. I'm going to take a background, click and drag this in, connect the output to the output, press 2 to preview that. I'll just move this over something like that. First of all, I want to switch these. So I'm going to click on my merge, press Control T, flip these, and shift spacebar after selecting media in, shift spacebar, do a transform, T-R-A-N-S, and we got transform, add that in there. And I want to connect this not only to the yellow, but also to the blue mask. So I'm going to click on the output and click on this blue mask here. So when we select our merge, we can see our background isn't quite fitting here. So we can try to change the size. We can undo that, go to background and go to width and height, uncheck auto resolution. Adjust the height. We don't want this black color, obviously. So let's set this under the color tab here, solid color, go to gradient and one end around the top, one end around the bottom, following this angle here. I'm gonna set this black color to a bright yellow. So click this arrow, drop that down, bright yellow, and click on this triangle here and make this a darker red. Now we got our color set. Let's select this one and let's start bringing up the transparency so we can get the image faded in. For extra control, what I ended up doing was clicking in the middle, adding another point, and then you could make this more saturated if you want, more bright, darker, whatever suits your needs. Also, you could adjust the transparency one way or another. I like the look where the color starts to get solid towards the bottom, and then we could see the actual image more clearly towards the top, and you might need to shift this around, get the right look that you want. Maybe even add another one in here. If this is getting a little too transparent in the middle area, start to bring this down. All right, so yeah, I like that look. Nice stylized look there. So now what we want to do is merge this back into our original down here, and let's press 2 to preview that. Grabbing our transform, we can shift this over and down. And at that position, I think it's a little too red. So then I would come back in here and start to shift some of these over. If we want it really bright, we can make one more, move that over, take this one, make it almost white. Might need to change this just a little bit more. All right, so that's obviously too much. As for like a transition, this could be a really interesting effect. So just a little bit more adjustments here. If I'm not getting enough control, I could always come back into the gradient and move this. Also another idea for a transition there. So just adding a glow now, click on this merge here, press shift spacebar, G-L-O-W. Let's click on this soft glow, press enter. And this is a weird thing that happens. I don't know if this is a bug or not. Now we could see this half where it was invisible. Now it's there just without the glow. But if you go from frame to none on the glow node, that'll fix that up. So we don't want everything glowing. We could take the threshold and start to bring that up so only the brightest spots will glow. We could also adjust the glow size, take the gain down a bit. As you adjust these, you might realize that your background gradient is a little too bright and you might need to come back in here and adjust some of these colors so it's not getting too blown out. So now that we're here, let's select all these except for this bottom merge, shift spacebar, UND, underlay, deselect everything, then alt click the underlay, press F2, call this one photo left. And we could right click in here and go to set color and give it a matching color. And the next step is what we want to do is this is so bright and so hot, it should be giving off particles, right? So let's take a look at how we can add an effect like these particles up here. And we'll do that in the next video.